In this illustration, we'll analyze a floating sphere with a cavity. We are given that a cemented sphere of radius r has a cavity of radius small r, which is packed with the sawdust, and the relative density of cement and sawdust are 2.4 and 0.3 respectively. We are required to find the ratio of mass of cement to the mass of sawdust for which the sphere will float in water in completely submerged state. So here first we can write the mass of cement in the sphere will be 4 by 3 pi r cube minus small r cube, because we have subtracted the cavity volume from the total volume, multiplied by 2.4 rho of water, that is the density of cement. Similarly, we calculate the mass of sawdust in the sphere. This will be 4 by 3 pi small r cube multiplied by 0.3 times rho of water. And we know for floating, we can write the weight of water displaced by the whole sphere, as we are given that it is in completely submerged state. That would be balancing the total weight of the sphere. So here we can write the sphere weight mg will be balancing v rho water g. So in this situation, mass we can substitute as 4 by 3 pi r cube minus small r cube multiplied by 2.4 rho water, here g we can cancel out here only, plus this 4 by 3 pi small r cube multiplied by 0.3 rho water is equals to total volume as 4 by 3 pi r cube multiplied by rho water. If we simplify this relation here, 4 by 3 pi and rho w gets cancelled out. On simplifying this, we are getting 1.4 r cube is equals to 2.1 small r cube, which gives us the value of r cube by small r cube is equals to 3 by 2. And in this situation, if we calculate the ratio of masses, here we can continue. The ratio of mass of cement to mass of a sphere, we can divide these two values. So that will be 4 by 3 pi r cube minus small r cube multiplied by 2.4 rho water divided by, this is 4 by 3 pi small r cube multiplied by 0.3 rho water. Here 4 by 3 pi rho water all gets cancelled out. So this will give us mc by ms, mass of cement to that of sawdust, is equals to this r cube by r cube here we are having is 3 by 2. So this 3 by 2 minus 1 multiplied by this 2.4 by 0.3 is 8, which comes out to be 4. That is the result of this problem.